So good afternoon, everyone. So this class is for the SCST students for preparing higher education under the scheme AICT Prerana conducted by Erode Secondary Engineering College, Perumbavoor, Tamil Nadu, and myself, J. Arun Prasad, Assistant Professor, Civil Department, Erode Secondary Engineering College. So today in this class, we will be discussing about geomatic engineering. On civil gate syllabus of civil engineering. In this class, we will be discussing about surveying. Okay. So, surveying, we will be discussing about the basic surveying. So, what is the surveying? Surveying is nothing but it is the science and art of determining the relative positions of points. Okay. The points will be above or below the earth surface. And also locating the points in the field. So if you want to determine the position of a point in a land, so if you are going to construct any land, structure in the land surface, okay. Example, you are going to construct a shopping mall in a land. So for constructing the shopping mall, you will be construct, you will have to place the column. Okay, column in the sense, you will, in general term, you will be saying the pillar, right? But in a commonly technical term, we'll be calling it as columns, right? That vertical member. Where you have to place the columns? Where you have to place the beams? So everything you have to identify, right? Before that, the land should be in the horizontal surface. There should not be any undulations up and down. So for that, we have to make the land in an equal manner. So for that, we are going to determine some points in the field. So you will be determining the points using a branch of science that is in civil engineering, that is called surveying. Okay. So we have saw this about surveying, the basic things. And in surveying, those who are doing the surveying, those who are handling the surveying equipments, they are called as a surveyor. Yeah. Those who are going to deal with the surveying, those who are going to measure the land or whatever, they will be calling it as a surveyor. So those who are working as a surveyor, they will be having a 5 important phases. That is, they have to do the 5 important steps. They have to decide which method they are going to implement, which equipment they are going to implement, and where they are going to place the equipment, and they are going to determine the points. That is, commonly we'll be saying, overall we'll be saying a decision making. Next, after placing the equipment and selecting the method and deciding the points, they have to do the field work. That is, they have to measure the points, they have to collect the data, right? So those things can be done by the particular method and the particular equipments. And after it, they are going to collect them all the data, and they have to do the calculations so that they can determine the final output. So they have to do this computing and data processing. Okay. And after that, they have to do the mapping and data representation. They have to, as I told in the previous class, no, whatever you are seeing, that you have to do in a paper or in a soft copy in a proper format. Okay. So those things we have to represent in a map or plot or chart, whatever thing. Next, we will be doing is stakeout. So we are going to do the proper output method in the particular locations. So these are the 5 phases they will be dealing with. Okay. So next, the objective of surveying. Why we are going to do the surveying in any construction or any buildings or whatever? What is the need of the surveying? So it is that primary objective will be for the preparation of plan of a building or a land, whatever thing, estate or whatever building. It may be the residential building, a highways, a harbor or railways, whatever thing. To prepare a plan, we need a correct area, right? Correct area, how much required field we required, how the area will be, everything we need to require, right? So these things can be done by only the surveying. Next, another objective is we can determine the position of the surface of the earth. Okay, as I told already, no, in geotechnical surveying, where the mining is there, where the soil type, what are the soil type below the surface, everything can be determined by this type of surveying. Okay. See, I am not teaching the new one. What we discussed in the previous class only, no, that only we are going. I am going recalling now. Okay. So after I am asking this, I am recalling. I will be asking the question again in this. So listen carefully. So what are the uses of surveying? So okay, we know the objective. So first we know the what is surveying, right? So where the surveying will be useful? In which area it will be useful? For preparation of topographical maps, right? Like a maps in a hill or valley or river. The map will be showing only river. The map will be showing only the town area. So those cases, this topographical map usage, no, there surveying will be useful for collecting the data for that. And for preparing the cadastral map, likewise we are using the Google Maps, right? If you go in the Google Maps, we have options, satellite, traffic, and so many options. The cadastral map is nothing but it is like a boundaries. Only it will show the boundary alone. Okay, next, engineering map. So it will show the what are the technical details as an engineer you want to know. Everything will be represented in that map. Likewise, road. What are the roads available in a street, in a place, in a town or village? Everything will be represented in that map. Okay. Or if you want to know the railway tracks between the two areas, in that map the details will be shown. Or if you want to know the details of canals, okay, in those area also this map will be useful. So these maps can be prepared by only surveying. Just you can't do as it is. Okay, so you have to survey and you have to do. So next, similarly for our military maps. Okay, what are the boundaries between the two countries? Roads and railways between two states, bordering, everything will be you can show in that. Next is contour map. So it will show the best possible route for railways and roads. If any hilly area is there, any reservoir dam is available, any shortcut we want to know. So those things, everything will be can be determined and can be found in the contour map. Next, archaeological, no. So you can see the where the ancient things available, everything. It will not be like, not like a map, it will be like a details will be factored and kept in that. Okay. Next, geological means in what are the soil available in the particular area. So if we have a different area and what are the if we have different areas, like example, you have a three or four areas in the map, and three or four areas also we have different type of soils. Or below that soil we have different type of resources like coal, oil, petrol, likewise. These things can be determined and shown in the geological map. Okay. So next we have discussed about surveying, types of surveying, right? So we have saw about surveying, then usage, objectives. So what are the types now? Because generally we will be having a plain surveying and geotech surveying. Okay, plain surveying will be having a only that above the surface what are things available, everything will be discussing. Geotechnic, no, below the surface what are things will be having, will be surveying below the earth surface. We have discussed, right? In plain surveying, no, example I told that earth is a spherical shape, but while seeing in the map, no, we will be seeing in a plain surface, right? That is the 3D is converting into 2D. So whatever you are seeing in the naked eye, everything while you are converting in a art form, that is in a paper form, you will be drawing only the 2D images. So here in plane surveying, you know, the area can be surveyed that is less than 250 square kilometer. Okay, next is geodetic surveying is nothing but it can be used more than 250 square kilometer. So here, no, if you are going to survey a 360 degree angle, so everything, no, you can use this. Okay, next, secondary classification. This is the common thing we are using nowadays. In this also, chain survey. See, you can see the based on the instrument types. What are the instrument you are using? These are the instrument names, equipment name. Chain surveying, I told that pictures, right? I saw the picture. It will be like a links. 25 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter chain will be there. Just you have to throw the chain and you have to measure the distance. So these chain survey and all used before so many years, before the introduction of tapes. Nowadays we are measuring the distance by tapes, right? In site we are using the tapes, right? For measuring the distance, scale tapes. Before that, chain surveys were used. And compass, it will be like a compass. You will be having a showing the distance and you will be showing the angle. And plane table surveying, I shown the picture, right? You will be having a table, you will be having a bubble tube, right? And you will be having compass also in that. And you will be having Adelaide. And in that, you will be seeing from one end, and another end, you will be having a thread and you will be seeing it. Next, theodolite, no? We have seen the image like a microscope, we have saw an equipments, right? Those are the theodolite equipments. Dumpy level we have, theodolite we have. Then advanced one we have a total stations. Equipment names, these and all. Okay. And tachometric survey is also a type of surveying. We are using a theodolitic. Next to photographic survey is nothing but taking the photo and we are using it like a drone survey. I saw, no, by using a drones we can survey, right? And triangulation survey is a method. Okay, we'll be discussing this triangle survey and traverse survey and all. And based on the object, no, geological survey below the surface. Geological means nothing but geology is the meaning. Even you can see that below the surface, what are the things you have, you can identify. So mine survey, what are the mines available, archaeological, ancient objects available, military survey, boundaries. Next, we have a land survey. What are type of land? Agricultural land, coastal land, likewise. Okay, next, astronomical survey. Astronomical survey, it all right. Distance between the two stars and the two planets, likewise, we'll be discussing because we won't be going there. We'll be using the instrument from here and we'll be surveying, right? So, okay, so up to this, we have completed in the previous class, right? Any doubt in this? Okay, no doubt. Photogrammetry. So as I told, no, I was on a drone surveying. So here also same. So in the other type of survey, the photogrammetry is nothing but if you want to survey a land, so you can use that. So here they are using the airplane satellites. So nowadays they are using a drones. You take a photo of a land and in that node it will create a separate points. You can control that. You can create the point and you can measure the distance between the points. Okay, so next, boundary surveying is nothing but for determining the boundaries. Suppose you are buying a land and you're going to construct a building, right? So in the land we have a separate corners. Neighboring land will be there, neighboring field will be there. So you have to survey, right? How many area you have, and you have corners you have to survey. Then only you will be putting a fence, right? கம்பி கட்டி வைப்பாங்களா, ஃபென்சிங் போட்டு. ஸோ தோஸ் திங்ஸ் கேன் பி டன் ஆஃப்டர் த பவுண்டரி சர்வேயிங். ஓகே, ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் கண்ட்ரோல் சர்வேயிங் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் ஃபார் கண்ட்ரோலிங் அண்ட் த ஹரிசாண்டல் வெர்டிகல் மான்யூமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஸ் அ ரெஃபரன்ஸ் ஃபார் சர்வேயிங் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ். ஸோ திஸ் வில் பி த பெஞ்ச் மார்க் ஓகே ஃபார் அதர் சர்வேயிங் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ். ஃப்ரம் திஸ் ஒன்லி தே வில் பி ஸ்டார்டிங் த சர்வேயிங் லைக் வேஸ். So engineering surveying, what you are going to do for our survey, civil engineering buildings. Okay, so write down this, take down. So note on this. See, these things I am giving only for a single line or double line, okay, the definition. So you have to refer more about this and you have to write in the exams. If it is a MCQ types, then you have to remember the concept, you have to answer. Okay, regarding if you are going for any gate exam, whatever thing, you will be dealing with this type of basic questions. Okay, next you write down. So topographic survey, what is topography? I told, right, collecting the data and preparing the maps, right? Route survey, so here we have a routes, what are the type of routes. So here we have another type, seventh one, hydrographic surveying. As I told already, now if you want to build a structure in the water, there also you need to do the survey, right? So in those area, if you are doing a surveying, then there also you have to do the type of surveying of hydrographic surveying. So it is another name called bathymetric surveying. So these are some surveying histories. Okay, so how and when was surveying was, so just for information only. So you can see here when and where the surveying started. And everything, it was started in the beginning in the Egypt about 1400 BC. So they used the surveying equipment like a name called diopter. So they surveyed the Nile River there. Okay. So generally, how the surveying will be done, I'll be showing the method. We have already saw on type, two types, no? Traversing and triangulation. That will be the main important topic in the survey. Other than classification, that is an important topic. Okay. So these are some another histories. So the Romans, they have surveyed Middle Age. These are the histories of surveying. Just for information only, no need to note down this. So in the 18th and 19th century, they used the surveying equipments for mapping. So here only the measurement of distance. Okay. So I told no surveying in classification also you can see that chain surveying is the oldest technique, as I told, right? So in those days they are used, if you want to find the distance between the two points. So nowadays we have a scale, right? Or we have a tape. So they are not involved in surveying method. They used the surveying chain. So if it is a longer surveying, you say 30 meter, 20 meter, no, you can't use a scale there, right? So they use the chain only. A survey, who knows? Surveyors use this chain. So each chain will be of 66 feet long. Each link is of 0.66 foot. So each link is nothing but I have shown a picture, right? Surveying, we have a chain surveying, we have a link, right? Each link will be of 0.666 foot. Okay, so write down this. Write down chain surveying, below that you can write down this. Note it down there. Menu. Okay, write down. What on earth? So next we'll be discussing about the it's a very important thing in this. So units of measurement. Generally you have here this word acre. Right? Land will be measured in acres only. So acre is a unit of area equal to 43560 square feet. Okay, 1 acre is nothing but 43560 square feet, or in terms of chains, if you are saying 10 square chains. Okay, so in chain, no, the unit of length, it is a what you will say, what you are using the chains, no, for measuring, that is why we will call it as Gunter chain. That name is, so it is made up of heavy metal. It will be having 100 link based on the length. Okay, so it will be used by surveyor to measure the boundaries. So these things, this acre, these things, no, you have to know the units for measuring the area or length using the surveying equipments. So take down. So from this only for the questions will be asked in surveying. So note it down. Okay, so next we will discuss about hectare link. Okay, hectare is nothing but so metric unit of area, so which will be one area is 10,000 square meters or 2.471 acres. So it will be a highest number than acre. Acre would appear unit. Okay, So 1 hectare is nothing but 2.471 acres. And link I told, no, in chain. That is unit is nothing but it will be equal to 1/100 the length. That is 7.92 inches. Okay, wow. 1 inch is nothing but 25 mm approximately. And road it will be equal to the 1/4 of the area in the acres. And engineering same chain. I told the chain is of different types, right? Gunter chain is there, and engineering chain it will be having a 100 links. Okay, so next you note down this will be an important thing. So in second unit, the important topic that is in surveying, it will be classification of surveying. Next, method of measuring, that is how, what are the methods available. So here you have a direct method. So write down here. Okay. So I'll be showing that some direct methods. So take down this, it will be very important for you in terms of exam. Okay, so see here where the approximate result, no, we want to measure the distance. Here we can use the pacing method. Okay, so it is nothing but in this method, no. So you have to walk in over the line and count the number of paces. Okay, so here you can, if you want to measure in this type of a method, no. So you have to, if you want to measure between the 2 points, so just you draw the line between the 2 points. So from 1 point you start walking, and how to count the number of paces. Paces is nothing but, so in bracket they are given, see, 80 centimeter. How many paces it is covering from 1 point to another. So after that, counting that, just multiply the paces into the average length, how many distance it is there. Okay, so by doing this you will be covering the distance. Okay, so write down this. Down. So in this, no, we are multiplying the that is number of face by the average length, right? So length of the face is nothing but it will be varying by individual person, because how it will vary means by your height, weight, and physical nature, ground nature, and whether the place, the plane is in inclined and slopy nature, in how speed you are covering the 2 points. Okay, so this will be different. So we can't give correct value. This approximate method only. So we are already mentioned here, right? It is an approximate distance measuring method. See, the same thing advanced zone, now they are using in a highways for measuring the distance, kilometers. They will be traveling in a bike with a guy catching a wheel with him, right? This is also a type of this method. So next one is a Parkin instrument pathometer. So here it will be the same thing you'll be doing, just you have to keep that instrument on. So if you are on in the water, and if you are, it is like a stopwatch, okay, it will count the number of paces available, and after that you can note down the readings. Yeah. So next one is a pedometer. It is similar to the pathometer, but it will, here you have a knob. So like it will be like a normal stopwatch. You can reset the option. So you can, in this you can carry and register the distance walked by the person, how much he is walking. It's like a simple stopwatch, and it will measure the distance. Okay, well. And odometer, so I think you know, in all the vehicles will be available, like a speedometer. You know, speedometer, right? And we will be going directly to the methods chaining. Important thing I will be discussing about civil. So chaining, no? So measuring the distance between the 2 points by chaining. So it is the oldest method, and it will give the approximate result only. Nowadays we are using the steel tape. All the engineers, all the laborers, no, who are working in the construction field, they are using the tapes, right? I think you have noted this already, chaining. See, whatever I am repeating again, no, this is not, already we have saw these few things, and I am repeating again in while coming in next topic, okay? This time repeating again. So if you have already noted or known, no problem, leave it. And these things you have not repeat for you. And this one, type of chain. See, anyway, I will share this PPT in the Google Classroom. Just understand here, at chaining, no, we have so many types. So we have Gunter chain. Okay, so it will be 66 feet long. It will be 100 link. Link is nothing but one that steel tape, steel metal. Okay. So when it was developed and how many link it is there? One link is, it is of 0.66 feet. It is 7.9. We have discussed this also, right? So engineering chain. So it will be of 1 feet long, and it is used for the engineering purpose. And engineering tape, that modern we are using, right? So it will be of 1/4 inch or 3/8 inch steel tapes. 100 feet, 200 feet, 300 feet. Okay.